My name is Deborah Moelis. I'm a senior associate architect here at Handel Architects. I've been with the firm for 21 years since the inception of the firm. For our site, it was a residential project. We have an expertise in residential and a relationship with Hudson. And so that's how the project came to us. And we wanted to do something really special for Cornell. And Hudson is a developer that's very interested in sustainability. They've done some incredibly aggressive buildings. And their partner is Related. And Related is extremely ambitious as well, has very ambitious sustainability goals. So it's kind of the perfect storm of developers, Cornell, institutional, you know, they want to do something great and then make something beautiful that's also functional for the students. You know, the full facade, we understand very easily, especially the main body of the facade is actually very simple. It's the connections at the top and the bottom, right? It's how the building meets the ground, the ins and outs at the base, and how it folds up at the top, that they get tricky conditions. Design-wise for us, you know, we wanted to make a beautiful building first, right? So working with the PHPP model and being able to understand how much glass we could have, how thick the facade really needed to be, because our facade is variated. It's that push and pull that we really worked hard on with Lois to try and understand the average R value. So it's not just a straight R value. We have an average R value of about 20. And some areas are much higher and a few areas are a little lower. Also, the panels are a certain width and a certain height, and they have a certain join pattern. So that joinery pattern shows up on the facade. So for us, where every joint is became a very big driver of how the building would ultimately look. The continuity of the facade here is really important for passive house. What's fantastic is that it is a compact shape. It is facing south. It has very few 90-degree corners. We are looking at one here, but the other corners are softer. By way of a case study, something that we want to talk about a little bit is the facade anchors. So all the way around the perimeter of the plan, happening over 3,000 times, the facade is anchored to the building. The continuity of the air barrier, which wants to pass right by that connection, is broken because of the existence of this facade anchor. We're still working on how this is going to be actually executed. But something that's been really fantastic for this project is the introduction of this INTELLO, the air barrier. We've developed, working with 475, how this red line here is what we need to be our continuous air barrier. This is inside and this is outside. This steel tube is just for this performance mock-up. In our current project, this will be concrete. The panel will come to the site, will be fastened via this helpful and anchor. And this piece of air barrier will sort of be flapping and come unfastened. And then the panel will be set in place. And then that piece of air barrier will be continued and this piece of tape will seal it off. At the bottom of the anchor, that's actually even more challenging. This piece of INTELLO will be taped onto the underside of the Howfelin anchor. The installation of that INTELLO is scheduled to occur on the day of installation of the panel. So a man needs to actually hold back this flap. The panel gets installed and then the flap gets taped to maintain the continuity of the air barrier. This all has to do with access issues, right? All of this is about access and it's about sequencing. And so the better that you can plan in advance, the more chance you have of a successful project. And so we've been working countless hours, and the moment we received this drawing was really a humongous step forward for the project. We were really very, very excited about getting this far, and we really hope to see this executed. Whether it's not exactly like this in the field, it will need to be something like this to maintain this continuity of the air barrier. For this project, we've had to learn about a lot of different materials, these gaskets that go around pipes, and every pipe, this is something that needs to occur in sequence. Again, it's a very simple gesture to take a gasket and put it over a pipe, but it needs to be done in the correct sequence. If it's not, you lose your opportunity. And so communicating gaskets, tapes, different types of materials that the contractor has never used before is part of the job of the architect. And we've developed a tape schedule key into our drawings. It's just like any other piece of construction equipment. You know, it's just like gypboard. We key in gypboard and we key in ceramic tile. So we're starting to want to key in gaskets, different types of tapes, anything on our details. We need to show it, call it out, put it on a schedule, and then it's in the project. The clearer we can be in our specs and even in supplemental documents of how this thing gets executed, the better it will be. Because the first question is, what do we do? Why is it different? How is it different? Tell me, I want on a sheet of paper, how is this different? That's very hard to summarize, right, on a sheet of paper. And we're trying to do that, to get as clear and as concise as we can, but it's incredible. It is complicated. The ERVs on the roof, that's also new for us. We have fresh air being delivered to every single room. Never done that before, for sure. Yeah, the prefabricated way also have to go that way. I agree, because having the control of putting the windows in the shop, I mean, I've seen the windows go in the field, and it's not okay anymore. We should be putting them in the shop, bringing these panels in, having as few connections as possible. I mean, it seems really obvious to me that this is the way to go. I can't really draw a building anymore without saying, well, we're going to use a panelized system, right? You know, why would you do it any other way? Well, you know, we are looking to change the way buildings are built. You know, we want to show with this project that it is possible, that it costs not terribly much more, that you'll make that back. You know, there's all dorms, hotels, low-income housing, institutional housing, it should all, anything that the owner is paying the bills for, this should calc out. Any New York City housing project absolutely should be going this route. There's really no question. And also, the environment is healthier on the inside, the facade will be healthier and more durable, the materials will last longer, so that's better for any sort of public projects. So you asked if I've drank the Kool-Aid, definitely, you know. I believe it all. It seems that if it works, it will be great.